Humanity is poised on the threshold of its return to the lunar surface. This time, in partnership with a pioneering alliance between NASA and SpaceX, the mission goes beyond simply planting a flag and leaving a footprint. The goal is far more audacious: to establish a sustainable outpost on the lunar surface. The most remarkable aspect of this mission lies in SpaceX's ambition to achieve it solely with its Starship vehicle. Starship will not only facilitate the transportation of astronauts to the moon, but will also play a vital role in the construction and maintenance of a lunar base. How SpaceX will realize this bold vision? Let's dive deeper into today's NR Studio episode. During a presentation at Starbase Texas, Elon Musk, the visionary behind SpaceX, outlined the company's ultimate goal: the establishment of Moonbase Alpha. This lunar outpost will be built using the Starship spacecraft, using a variant of the Human Landing System specifically designed for this purpose. Starship HLS is engineered to transport astronauts from lunar orbit to the lunar surface and back. In line with NASA's Artemis program, the Starship Human Landing System, HLS, under the Human Landing System contract, serves a critical function in NASA's efforts to achieve a manned lunar landing. Similar to its standard variant, the Starship HLS stands 50-60 meters tall and is 9 meters in diameter, with the capacity to transport more than 100 tons to the lunar surface. Equipped with 6 Raptor engines, the HLS variant will utilize this powerful propulsion system during launch, landing, and ascent phases. However, the HLS features important differences from the conventional Starship in several aspects. Since it does not penetrate the Earth's atmosphere, the heat shield and flight control surfaces that are the hallmarks of Starship are eliminated. These changes minimize mass, thereby reducing the frequency of refueling tanker launches required after the spacecraft reaches orbit. Furthermore, in the absence of a reentry system, methane and liquid oxygen tanks can be adapted for alternative uses. Given that the spacecraft is currently on the moon, a notable characteristic of the lunar Starship is its white exterior, which replaces the traditional stainless steel design. This modification significantly improves thermal management, a critical factor for enduring the harsh conditions of the lunar environment. Utilizing an existing Starship design to construct the lunar landing system, as opposed to inventing an entirely new system, presents numerous advantages. NASA has underscored the importance of reducing alterations to the vehicle configuration and standardizing the design of the HLS, as this approach will facilitate a more efficient development process. This methodology obviates the necessity for superfluous testing, evaluation, and verification procedures typically associated with entirely novel designs. In doing so, SpaceX can expedite production schedules, guaranteeing that the spacecraft is ready for timely mission integration and deployment. Through these innovative adaptations, SpaceX and NASA stand poised at the threshold of history, aiming not merely to visit the moon, but to establish a sustained presence. Nevertheless, it appears that NASA may not have fully recognized the distinctive benefits of constructing a lunar habitat utilizing SpaceX's Starship, especially its potential evolution into a permanent installation following its initial role as a lunar landing system. This visionary concept exploits the vehicle's entirety of internal volume, encompassing its fuel tanks, to establish a livable environment. Herein lies the methodology for achieving this transformation, along with the groundbreaking process that underpins it. The establishment of a permanent lunar base necessitates substantial infrastructure, advanced equipment, and vital supplies to facilitate research and support long-term human habitation. To realize this objective, SpaceX suggests deploying 2 Starships to the moon. One will accommodate astronauts, while the other, an uncrewed vessel, will deliver provisions. The supply Starship will be equipped with the essential tools, materials, systems, and provisions required for the construction and upkeep of the base. Prior to exiting Earth's orbit, both spacecraft will be refueled to facilitate the translunar injection maneuver. The chosen landing site is the Shackleton Crater, located at the lunar South Pole. This location presents itself as an exemplary candidate for a permanent lunar base, attributable to its distinct environmental conditions. The summits of the crater's rim benefit from nearly uninterrupted sunlight, a vital characteristic for the generation of solar energy. Concurrently, the interior of the crater is shrouded in constant darkness, presenting an opportunity for the accumulation of water ice, which is vital for supporting life and producing fuel. Shackleton additionally provides a direct line of sight to Earth, enabling seamless communication without interruption. These benefits render it an optimal site for lunar habitation. Upon arrival, astronauts will utilize Starship's elevator system to make their descent to the surface. Their preliminary responsibilities will encompass the remote deployment of power reactors, solar panels, and radiators, in addition to the transfer of any residual fuel into appropriate storage tanks. Upon the successful completion of these preliminary steps, the endeavor to convert Starship into a lunar base can commence. The transformation process is significantly dependent on robotic support to reduce astronaut exposure to the Moon's inhospitable environment. Cosmic radiation, extreme temperatures, and the constraints of mobility inherent to extravehicular activity suits present considerable challenges. Consequently, remotely operated robots will undertake the majority of construction tasks, thereby optimizing both efficiency and safety. The initial significant phase entails orienting the Starship in a horizontal configuration. This necessitates alleviating stress on the vehicle's structure by removing any non-essential equipment, including radiators and solar panels. The deployment of these systems externally from the vehicle facilitates a decrease in overall mass and contributes to a reduction in its center of gravity. The internal volume of the tanks within the payload area will be maintained at a minimal pressure to ensure structural integrity during maneuvers. The horizontalization process employs a hinge mechanism to facilitate the tilting of the vehicle. In the initial phase, the elevator cables will disengage and secure themselves to bear the weight of the vehicle, whereas in the concluding stages, a scissor lift will facilitate the transfer of the load to the ground. The vehicle will ultimately be positioned between two parallel ridges of accumulated regolith, effectively inhibiting rolling and offering structural reinforcement. With the Starship oriented horizontally, the subsequent procedure involves fully depleting its fuel tanks. Residual fuel is vented to mitigate any potential fire hazards during ensuing modifications. These vacant tanks, in conjunction with the cargo bay, constitute the underpinning for the livable zones of the base. Notably, the mere conversion of the fuel tanks results in a space nearly 2.5 times greater than the habitable volume of the International Space Station. Subsequent to the meticulous cleaning of the tanks to eliminate any fuel remnants, construction commences with the installation of insulation and radiation shielding along the interior walls. Subsequently, additional floors are incorporated into the structure, which may consist of either a singular roomy level characterized by lofty ceilings or several tiers, each nearly 3 meters in height. These design alternatives emphasize comfort while striving to alleviate the psychological strain associated with residing in a limited space. The interior is strategically segmented into functional zones designed to accommodate the astronauts' everyday requirements as well as their scientific endeavors. These encompass both private and communal living spaces, featuring sleeping pods, a kitchen, and a lounge area. The scientific facilities will encompass a laboratory dedicated to experimental endeavors, including soilless cultivation of plants aimed at fostering sustainable food sources. Moreover, a compact medical bay designed specifically for the treatment of injuries and illnesses will be established. Ultimately, installations for critical systems, including communication, electricity, ventilation, and water distribution, will involve the placement of cables and pipes. Notwithstanding the significant alterations made to the interior of the Starship, it remains imperative to implement an additional safeguard, which entails encasing the base in a layer of lunar regolith. This is essential for protection against meteoroids, which present a considerable hazard on the Moon owing to its absence of an atmosphere. On our planet, meteoroids generally incinerate upon atmospheric entry, preventing their descent to the surface. However, the Moon's unprotected position renders it susceptible to high-velocity impacts. A stratum of regolith measuring 5 meters in thickness will be strategically applied atop the foundational layer, representing the loose soil that overlays a significant portion of the lunar surface. This protective shell not only shields against meteoroid impacts, but also offers supplementary insulation. This groundbreaking strategy reconfigures the Starship HLS into a sustainable lunar habitat, one that can effectively facilitate prolonged missions while propelling humanity's endeavors in lunar exploration. By repurposing the vehicle, SpaceX enhances its functionality, transforming a once single-use lander into a sustainable operational base. The procedure demonstrates efficiency and cost-effectiveness while harmonizing with the broader objectives of establishing a human presence beyond our planet. Upon becoming operational, The base will serve as a foundation for scientific exploration, technological advancement, and the strategic preparation for upcoming missions to Mars and beyond. Its positioning at the lunar South Pole presents exceptional prospects for investigating lunar geology, extracting resources, and evaluating life support systems within an authentic extraterrestrial setting. Moreover, the foundation could function as a catalyst for further exploration of outer space, bolstering humanity's status as an interplanetary species. In summary, the evolution of Starship into a lunar base signifies a pivotal advancement in the realm of space exploration. This multifunctional vehicle not only serves as a lunar lander, but also transforms into a habitable structure, thus expanding the frontiers of off-world construction and sustainability. Through the utilization of cutting-edge design and robotic support, SpaceX is set to transform humanity's connection with the Moon, establishing the foundation for a future in which enduring lunar settlement becomes a tangible reality. Undoubtedly, for humanity to sustain long-term habitation on the Moon, it is imperative to first tackle the essential requirements of air, water, and food. The Moon's atmosphere lacks oxygen. However, its surface is enveloped in a stratum of sand-like material comprised of metallic elements and oxygen-rich compounds. Although we commonly associate oxygen with the atmosphere we inhale, substantial quantities are also sequestered within the lunar regolith. Deriving oxygen from this substance could furnish astronauts with a renewable source of breathable air for forthcoming missions. Remarkably, a mere 20 grams of lunar regolith harbors sufficient oxygen to sustain an astronaut's life for approximately 20 minutes. NASA has recently showcased the viability of this process at the Johnson Space Center in Houston, where researchers adeptly extracted oxygen from simulated lunar regolith. This assessment confirmed the feasibility of directly extracting oxygen from the lunar resources, thereby providing an essential support system for human survival and potentially facilitating future space exploration endeavors. Although water is more scarce on the Moon than on Earth, it exists notably as ice. The lunar South Pole, designated as a future settlement site, presents the greatest promise for the discovery of ice deposits. This water will fulfill several integral functions, sustaining human existence, facilitating agricultural production, and advancing propulsion technology. Water will play a pivotal role in the cultivation of crops on the Moon, representing a significant advancement towards the establishment of a sustainable food supply. Post-purification, water becomes suitable for consumption and daily tasks, thereby obviating the necessity for astronauts to rely on recycled urine as they do presently. In addition to supporting human life, water can undergo electrolysis to yield hydrogen and oxygen. The resultant hydrogen and oxygen can subsequently be stored as liquid propellants for rocket engines. This capability establishes the Moon as a prospective refueling hub for missions exploring the outer reaches of the solar system. Energy is critical to sustaining lunar endeavors, and helium-3 extraction could offer a pioneering solution. Helium-3, a light and sustainable isotope of helium consisting of 2 protons and 1 neutron, has long been considered a promising candidate for nuclear fusion power. Unlike traditional nuclear reactions, helium-3 fusion produces negligible radioactive waste, making it an attractive option for sustainable energy solutions. Lunar regolith exhibits much higher concentrations of helium-3 than found on Earth, due to billions of years of accumulation facilitated by the solar wind. When successfully harvested, helium-3 has the potential to power fusion reactors, providing a sustainable and efficient source of energy for future lunar bases and Earth-based systems. Effective communications will be critical to the development of a lunar base, and SpaceX's Starlink system is well-positioned to address this challenge. Laser communications technology, which NASA has been researching since 2013, has proven its ability to transmit data at unprecedented speeds between Earth and the Moon. SpaceX has integrated optical lasers into its Starlink satellites, enabling data transmission speeds of up to 200 gigabits per second. This groundbreaking innovation allows Starlink to build a space-based mesh network that seamlessly connects terrestrial locations and remote spacecraft, eliminating the need for nearby base stations. For example, during the Polaris Dawn mission, Starlink effectively facilitated high-speed internet connectivity for SpaceX's Dragon spacecraft. This incredible capability means that Starlink has the potential to create a vast communications network connecting Earth, the Moon, Mars, and spacecraft en route. Leveraging this infrastructure, Remote outposts and missions will benefit from uninterrupted data transfer and communications, improving operational requirements and facilitating real-time coordination. The establishment of a lunar base is just the beginning of a broad and ambitious vision. The ultimate goal is to transform the Moon into a thriving outpost that serves as a springboard for advanced space exploration. This endeavor goes beyond competing for national honor or technological dominance. It marks a significant milestone in the evolution of humanity as a spacefaring species. By harnessing oxygen and water extraction, advancing innovative energy sources like helium-3, and deploying advanced communications networks like Starlink, humanity is building the foundation for a sustainable existence beyond our planet. Each advancement moves us closer to a future where the Moon goes beyond its role as a stepping stone and becomes a fundamental foundation in our quest for the stars. That's it for today's episode. See you in the next episode.